Good afternoon. And welcome to St. Pius X Church, and welcome to all who are visiting us today. We extend a special welcome to those who are praying with us through the streaming of this Mass. We pray for all your intentions, those you've sent into us, as well as those you are holding in your hearts at this time. We invite you, our viewers, to continue to send your intentions to us. You may email them to us or call them into our office. At the end of Mass, it is our practice to pray three Hail Marys for the next one among us who will be called home by God. We invite you to join us in our prayer today. If you are interested in registering in our parish, we invite you to see a hospitality minister. They can be identified by their name tag lanyards. Let us take a moment to enter ourselves and to gratefully remember that we are in God's presence. Opening hymn this afternoon is number 519, Sing to the Mountain. Let us all stand and sing together, Sing to the Mountain, number 519.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our risen Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. On this eighth day of the octave of Easter, this Divine Mercy Sunday, we renew ourselves with the blessing through the baptismal waters. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless us through the water he has created and blessed, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. And as you receive the holy water, to receive it with the sign of the cross, the sign through which you were baptized. May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the Eucharist we share, bring us one day to the eternal banquet where he is Lord forever and ever. Let us pray. O God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was one of heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possession was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel sing his mercy and
a reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God, and when we love God and obey his commandments, for the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is known as Divine Mercy Sunday. The word mercy in English comes from the Latin misericordia. And if we take apart that word literally, misericordia, the first part literally means misery. Cordia, heart. So if someone shows you mercy, they're saying, I want to hold your misery in my heart. I want to take your misery from you and hold it in my heart. What a profound gift that is from God. That God says, I want to show you mercy. I want to take your misery from you, and I'll hold it, but I'll hold it in my heart because I love you. As we look at the gospel for today, no matter what year we are in the cycle of readings, A, B, or C, this second Sunday of Easter is always from the Gospel of John. And it's always the story of the upper room and then of Thomas. Jesus appears and says, Peace be with you. Whatever is causing you to not have peace in your life, I want to take that misery from you. Give it to me and I'll hold it in my heart. Whatever it is. Is it your health? Keep on giving it to me. Don't worry about it. Don't stress it. Keep giving it to me. Is it the health of someone you love? Give their health and your concern for them to me, and I'll hold it in my heart. If it's your financial situation, give it to me. If it's a relational situation, give it to me, and I'll hold it in my heart. So whatever is causing you to lack peace, keep giving it to me. It may have to be a constant thing, but keep giving it to me, and I'll hold it in my heart for you so that you don't have to experience it. Peace be with you. And then he breathes on them and says, Receive the Holy Spirit. Whoever sins you forgive are forgiven them. That is where we get our prayer of absolution in the sacrament of reconciliation. God, the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, has reconciled the world to himself and poured out the Holy Spirit for the forgiveness of sins. Receive the Holy Spirit. Whoever sins you forgive are forgiven them. It's always difficult to talk about sin because usually people tend to be one extreme or the other. One extreme being, oh, I don't sin. I don't really do anything wrong. And especially for some of us senior people, Father, I never go anywhere. I never do anything. How can I do anything wrong? Well, there's the sin of omission. You might be omitting something. So you might not be doing something wrong, but are you omitting something that you should be doing right? So for the people that are at that end of the spectrum, I never do anything wrong. I don't sin. Take a look. Nobody in the world is perfect. And we have that saying, even a just person sins 7 times a day. So if you put yourself in the category of a just person, you better look at least 7 times a day. Now, the other end of the spectrum are the people that everything is a sin. It's black and white. It's scrupulosity. And the torture and the torment of being scrupulous. My heart breaks for people that struggle with that. Because everything is a sin. You know, you come into confession. You know, I didn't pray the right way. I lost concentration. I may have had some toothpaste in my mouth when I went to receive Holy Communion. I broke the fast. I mean, and it's not funny because people are really tortured by that stuff. And then they leave the confessional, they come back in, and Father, I don't know if I made a good confession just now. I think I need to go to confession again. And it's sad. It's sad because they really are feeling that torture. And so when you talk about sin and you have the two extremes, some people are saying, oh, he's talking about sin. It doesn't apply to me because I don't sin. And other people are saying, oh, he's talking about me because everything I do is a sin. It's like, oh, glory be to God. No, 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 no. There's some place in the middle of that. And to know that our sins are forgiven. And to not trust in our sins more than we trust in God. There is an image called the Divine Mercy image that our Lord gave to Saint Faustina, and he commissioned her to paint his portrait. And we have that on the left-hand side as you exit church, just near the baptismal font on the left-hand wall. But he told her to inscribe at the bottom, Jesus, I trust in you. Wow, think about that. Jesus, I trust in you. More than anyone or anything else, I trust in you. And I trust that you're going to work it out. Whatever it is that's causing me misery in my life, I trust that you're going to work it out. Now, he may not work it out to our satisfaction, to our plans. That can be very difficult. Because we look at what happened last week. Last week, he was crucified. He suffered, he died, he was buried. It sure didn't seem like that was working it out, did it? And Thomas was struggling to believe that it was worked out. All the rest of the guys were saying, the Lord is risen, we've seen him. Yeah, right. Yeah. No, I think he abandoned us. I think he left us. Don't think he's coming back. He's dead and buried. And he said, I want proof. I want to put my finger in the nail mark in his hands, and I want to put my hand in the wound in his side. Then I'll believe. And so Jesus reappears in the upper room. And this time Thomas is with them. And he wants to relieve Thomas of his misery. So he says, hey, Tom, come here. Can you imagine Thomas and what he's thinking? Oh my gosh, it really is him, isn't it? Hey guys, you were right. He is risen from the dead. Look at him. Thomas, come here. You said you wanted something from me. Here, put your finger in the nail mark in my hands. And take your hand and put it into the wound in my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe. I want to relieve you of the misery of your unbelief. That everything you said and you did when you followed me was not in vain. It's not in vain. It's going to work out, and it's working out right now. Come here. It was many years ago I saw a painting, and I cannot remember the artist who did it. But it's showing that depiction of the upper room with Thomas and Jesus. And Thomas is putting his hand into the wound in Jesus' side. And in this painting, you can see that Thomas has his hand in the side of Jesus almost up to his elbow. And that just blew me away. He's like sinking it into the Jesus side. Wow. Because Jesus wants to take his misery from him. Mercy, misericordia, taking our misery into his heart. So whatever is making you miserable this afternoon, give it to Jesus. Tell him that. Jesus, this is what's making me miserable, and I just want you to take it. I want you to hold it in your heart for me so that I don't have to hold on to it, at least for this moment. Give me a moment of peace. Give me a moment of relief from this misery. Jesus started the gospel by saying, "Peace be with you." When he appeared again, he said, "Peace be with you." And we remember that when he said it, when he was walking with the disciples, he said, "My peace is a peace the world cannot give." So when we've exhausted everything of the world and we're still lacking peace, when we still have misery, give it to Jesus. In prayer, tell him, "I don't want it. I want you to take it and hold it in your heart for me." Mercy, misericordia, that's the love of Jesus. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God's mercy endures forever, and so we can confidently bring our needs before the Lord, asking for the mercy we seek.
Today's response is, "Risen Lord, hear our prayer." For the church, that we may be bearers of God's mercy to all who need it most, especially those who find themselves doubting God's presence in their lives or in the world, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to armed conflict and to gun violence, so that all God's children may enjoy the peace that Jesus offers, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who struggle to believe in a merciful God in the face of evil and sin in the world, that Jesus' promise of his redemptive presence in a broken world may strengthen their faith and give them hope, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who follow Christ, that we may emulate the early Christian community as described in today's first reading, sharing what we have so that no person goes needy, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all burdened by poverty, that God will raise our awareness of those who are in need around us and free us to respond generously with both our time and resources. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
for our sisters and brothers who bear Christ's sufferings in body, mind, and spirit, for the dying, especially those who will die alone today, and for everyone our Father has called home this week, in particular for Patrick Roncone, Eusebio Martinez, Jean Icavangelo, Mike Colasbari, Nancy Brennan, Ellen Kelso, and for those whom this Mass is offered, we pray.
For those who are in need of healing in all ways of body, mind, and spirit, especially those among us, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Merciful God, your Son comes to us in time of need, granting us peace. Hear these needs of your people, and grant them in your mercy through your Son, Jesus, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles, the martyrs, St. Pius X, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, Salvatore our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us seek our daily bread, praying as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
A prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.